Hello and welcome to Off the Bench for the TAC Towards Zero. We have another jam-packed show tonight. Nathan Currie will join us from Channel 9 Local News, as will Hannah Driscoll from the Weekly Times, just to keep us updated with some of the big stories bubbling away across the state of Victoria. And we have another of our City of Ballarat features. This time, Brett Goods, the younger brother of Adam Goods, the Brownlow medalist, doing some good work with the Western Bulldogs and the City of Ballarat as I welcome the man from Geelong. 1977. He's just about that old, but the 1997 really? Best and fairest from the Cats, Liam Pickering. Welcome, Picks.
Good to be here, Swatty. Yes, another good show coming up, and I'm hoping that I'm looking forward to our special guest tonight, actually, because I've seen a lot of good players come through the region, and being from the greater Western Victorian area. He's a very good guest for us to have.
Well, I have not had much to do with the pre-show conversation. You've just seconded this man, had him in a corner for the last hour and a half, trying to pick his brains as to which young talent you can get your fingers around in the next couple of years. And this man is with the GWV, Greater Western Victoria's Rebels team, and his name is Phil Partington. Welcome, Phil.
G'day, guys. Great to be here.
You got some names for him because he needs some more people on his books.
Well, he's hit me up first of all. So he walked in the door, he hit me up straight away. So
that's how it works, Pardo, is that when you're a player manager, you need to get all the advice from these experts like Pardo. But let's get on to where your team's at, because it's been a really tight season in the TAC Cup this year. Not really expected last week from an outside perspective to be able to beat the might of the Bushies. Tell us how this all went down.
Well, we're 43 points down at three-quarter time and wasn't looking too good, to be honest, Pickers, but the boys kicked 8 goals to 1 point in the last quarter and we won by 6 points, which is a great enthusiasm for our lift of our team, and we were very pleased with the end result.
Yeah, absolutely. You would have been fabulous. I mean, they're a good team. We know there's plenty of talent coming out of the Bushies this year, Swatter. The ladder's really interesting because, well, look at the ladder there. You're 10th, right? So, but you're not far off 8th spot because, well, obviously, there's a top 8. So you're still a chance to make the finals.
We are a chance. We had a draw as well, so could have gone either way that day. And we've got some winnable games the last 3 games, so fingers crossed we'll make the finals. If you get 2 finals, you might get more drafted. That's a good thing for us.
You were the North Ballarat Rebels for as long as I can remember, and you changed the name. What was the thinking behind the name change?
Well, certainly with getting the girls in our program and taking over all of Western Victoria now with Warrnambool and also the Camperdown region, just a perfect fit for us to grab the Greater Western Victoria Rebels. So is it getting away for that North Ballarat name and just representing the whole region?
Hey, we've had Gerald Fitzgerald on this program.
Hey.
What?
Not Gerald. Jared Fitzgerald.
Gerald Fitzgerald on this program.
No, Jared Fitzgerald.
Fitzy, my apologies.
We all love Fitzy.
But I work with this bloke on a weekly basis and it's hard work. Fitzy's been a great ambassador for many years. He was involved at the senior level. He's returned to coach the Rebels. I couldn't think of a better qualified, more compassionate teacher of young men to improve their younger footy.
Yeah, he's got a great... I suppose you could say off-field sort of development agent, and works really hard with the players, and good teaching coach, which is really perfect for young boys.
Yeah, an interesting scenario, isn't it? Because, I mean, as the age group gets, you've got to have younger people around him. Fitzy's no spring chicken. He's been around, he's a mate of mine, but he's been around a long time.
And his birthday last week, actually, Pickers, so I won't say the age, though.
And you sent him a message for his birthday, considering you're great mates, didn't you?
Oh, of course I did.
Yeah, well
obviously
done.
I did.
Yeah, sorry, Pardo.
That's all right, yeah, but we've got some young people around him and got some good IT people around him as well, so the boys are really feeding off that.
Absolutely. Now, Swatter, the talent that's come out of this club,
breeding
this area, this area up around the stall area. This is your top 5, Pardo, over the last 11 years, 12 years you've been in this job.
You want to say any apologies before we go through the list, Pardo?
There's plenty of apologies. Last night I was going through the list, I'm thinking, well, geez, a few guys I've missed out here.
Yeah.
But, before my time, Adam Goods, Drew Petrie, and those sort of place. And in my 12 years, we've got some great players come through, and it was very hard to pick the top 5.
All right, let's go to number 5.
We've had a little look at... Jakey Lloyd was I'll say for the Stall Footy Club reunion, just quickly breaking away. And his old man, Tony, played in that game, kicked 3, didn't help him get over the line, Horsham, bad luck. But Jake, he's been a good story, hasn't he, Jake?
He has. He was a rookie, 19-year-old rookie, and probably the hardest work I've had at the Rebels. And look, if you can see him now playing the game of footy, just a really class player and doesn't waste a possession.
Let's roll through the rest. Hopper, we haven't seen a lot of Jacob Hopper yet, but massive upside.
Oh, upside. For 2 years for us, win the game off his own boot and just very professional.
Hugh McLuggage, what do you see, mate? What have you liked of his year this year? What have you seen of his year this
year? Not much.
All right, you haven't watched a lot of footy then. He's got a lot of talent, this kid.
He has, best and fairest for us last year. The Adam Goods Trophy and Morris Miller. You can just see the class he's got at the AFL now, and he's going to be a great player for future for the Brisbane Lions.
And Crouchy, of course, has got a brother, Matty, who's also a terrific young player.
Yeah, he couldn't really put the Crouch brothers there, actually.
You could have put them as a slash.
Could have slash.
Brad slash Matt.
But yeah, Matt's a good player, but Brad, in his 17th year for us, went in for 1 year, and he was outstanding. And the last one, Jeremy Cameron, the raw talent he's got, and a few injuries currently, but to see him where he's come from the Dartmoor Footy Club and hadn't played footy beforehand to get to the Rebels, and he's going to be a superstar.
Right, let's look at some of the guys currently playing. There's Tommy McDonald. Now, I was saying to you off camera that Tommy obviously has been defence mainly, but you said you played him as a forward.
Yeah, he played him as a forward as a 17, 18-year-old. Probably halfway through his 18-year-old, he came to the centre-half back, and look, he's just a class person, very committed person, gets the best out of himself each week.
Jeremy Cameron there, of course, nailing Richmond earlier in the year. He's Hopper. What about some of these players that Pardo's missed out? The please explain. This is Cedric Cox. This kid's got huge talent.
Yep.
Playing for the Brisbane Lions at the moment. Well, let's go through a few of them. The McDonald boys. Mm. Daniel Rioli was in your program.
He was, yeah. Daniel probably, as an 18-year-old, really came about. And as a 17-year-old, pretty lazy, Dan. And he's the first one to admit that too. But as an 18-year-old, you see him come through and kick some really classy goals. And his combine was outstanding. Now he's an AFL superstar. He's really good for the Richmond Footy Club.
He is. No Chaplin. No Brown brothers, Nathan and Mitch.
I wouldn't go there, Pickers, because Pardo's number one on his list was Jeremy Cameron. You drove to Dartmoor and couldn't get him signed on your book. So move on.
Very true.
Long 4 hour.
Very
long
true.
4 hour drive, Pickers.
Still doing
it. It was a long drive.
Absolutely filthy. Yeah.
A long drive to get no result. Right, now let's get through to this ground that we're looking forward to. Mars Stadium. This is absolutely sensational what you've done here. We can't wait to get up there for the Bulldogs game next weekend.
Well, it's great for the Rebels, one of our major partners in Mars, having a stadium named after. It's great for Western Victoria, not just Ballarat. If Pickers coming from Store to go watch an AFL footy game when you're a young bloke, probably take 4 or 5 hours. It's going to take 2 hours for West Victoria residents to get to a game. And 11,000-seat stadium. So looking forward to the big game next week.
Now, is it true that you had a dream? You and Fitzy had a dream? this happening a few years ago now?
No, I wouldn't say it was a dream. We, Mark Patterson, the CEO of the football club, then we had a bit of a think tank about 12 years ago, and it was a sort of a blue horizon, blue sky sort of think tank. And we had Horizon 1, which was 1 to 2 years. Horizon 3 was 5 to 10. And blue sky was our dream, basically. And we all sat down, and there was about 5 or 6 in this little meeting, and we thought, an AFL venue at Ballarat, at then the Northern Oval. So, and then lobbying and things like that with the government, and to see it, finish up now is just a really proud moment, not just for the city of Ballarat, but for Western Victoria.
Absolutely.
Well, build it and they will come, Pardo.
That's true.
They're about to turn up next week. Congratulations on the efforts of everybody involved up there, including the Western Bulldogs, and the work that they're doing. And good luck for the rest of the home and away season. Let's hope that your team gets into the finals in the TAC
Cup.
Thanks
very much, guys.
There we go. That was Phil Partington. He's the man, the talent manager for GWV Rebels. Hey, Pickers, we're going to have a look at our Carlton Draft team of the week. Carlton Draft, Victorian born and bred since 1864.
Yeah, it's a Lindenau Football Club, and Lindenau, the Cats, they are. They won 7 premierships, as you can see there. They've had some local legends too.
Young Heathy. Our legends.
Heathy and his old man.
Yep.
Heathy Senior is a bit of a legend up there, I can tell you that right now. So Cowley and Chris Blanford and Luke Dyer, these type of guys are all there. Well, I remember Brett Cowley, you all remembered him. Here Cats. They are celebrating. This was a premiership last year in the East Gippsland Football League. Actually went up and did a weekend with them a couple of years ago, and Fev played one of those one-off games and kicked about 14, didn't move out of the goal square.
Right, well, nothing's changed, and we might cover his game, Melton South, a little bit later on. We've got to take a break. Appreciate Phil Partington coming in. When we take a break and come back, Nathan Currie from Channel 9 Local News, the Off the Bench program, all thanks to our very dear friends at the TAC and their important road safety campaign Towards Zero, which means safer speeds, road users and vehicles. Means that serious injuries and a zero road toll is possible. Nathan Currie, up next.
Shepparton, talking to local leaders about our Towards Zero strategy and action plan. the TAC can help by funding extensive infrastructure. We can talk to the public about road safety messages and how we behave on the roads. But what we can't do is influence every single person, and that's where community leaders are so important.
Getting that message out to the community requires leaders from many different parts of our community. From a council point of view, we're heavily involved in the Cool Heads program, which is run by our local police here, and that's proved to be very successful over the past so many years. To have zero road deaths, a lot of people think that's impossible. I personally don't think it's impossible at all. So we'll be pushing that as much as we possibly can.
We all need to get behind it and you know, teach our young people, teach our families, teach everyone that it is a message that we need.
One of the things that the TAC is doing is funding extensive infrastructure, particularly on the Midland Highway, where we're seeing barrier systems go in, and then a number of other infrastructure solutions like roundabouts, traffic signals, all going in to protect the local community. For the broader Global Valley area, we've got the Hume Highway. It's basically being overhauled from end to end, so from Albury right down to Melbourne, you can drive on a very, very safe road by mid-2018.
I think it's a really bold goal, and I think it's brilliant by the TAC to be so excited and so passionate about getting to this Towards Zero. So I'm absolutely behind the TAC and their goal to Towards Zero, and I reckon we can do it.
Welcome back to Off the Bench, all thanks to our great mates, the TAC, and the important game plan series which they are continuing to take across the great state of Victoria. In Shepparton a couple of weeks ago, great to see some of the famous faces of past football players, Boomer Harvey, Anthony Stevens, Scotty Cumming, Campbell Brown, and of course Craig Hutchison. And also equally, great to see so many people of influence in the local community getting on board with this really important campaign. So well done to everybody there and the fine folk of Shepparton. Time now for our Country Footy Roundup. And that's all thanks to Greyhound Racing supporting 3,000 Victorian jobs as we welcome Channel 9's budding media star, Nathan Currie. Welcome, Nath.
Thank you, Swato. Good evening, boys.
Yeah, good evening to you, Nathan. But I'll tell you what's in our desk.
Oh, boy.
What?
You talk about being the best clubman on two occasions. Now, this is you over in Perth.
Oh, no. Look at this.
Now, having a bit of a kick.
This is a stitch-up.
All you had to do was hit the target. you hit the bloody cameraman.
Poor Foggo. Yep. Now, I can explain, boys. Now, Cam McCarthy had just been traded to the Dockers, and they needed somebody to kick the footy to him so they could just film him kicking a bit. All my kicks hit the target, and the one time they film me, it hits poor Foggo from Fox.
You know, it's like football players trying to be people in the media. We just don't do it. So stay off the green stuff, mate. Stay off the green stuff. Nicely done. What about the North Central Football League, where we start tonight?
Yeah, another dominant performance from Witchy Proof, Narraport. They were far too good for Wedderburn. Second time this year they've pumped the Redbacks by 100 points. Now, Corey Jones, the former North Melbourne player, he plays for the Demons. He's leading the goal kicking this year in the league with 64. He kicked another two goals and was named in the best for the Demons. The damage was done really in the second quarter. From the end of the first to the start of the third, they booted 10 unanswered goals. So and we'll have a look at the ladder now. No surprises that they're on top. They are flying.
Yeah, they're not going to be hard to catch from there, I would have thought. See, like, probably the only real dangers. Couldn't imagine the rest outside of, you know, Birchett maybe, but you wouldn't think so. Now we go into the Ballarat Football League.
Yeah, we can see the big man Fev on screen for Melton South. Now, he talked a big game up pre-game because he was at the tribunal last week for abusing an umpire, got off, said he was keen to help the Panthers to a big win. He kicked four and actually went up into the midfield for a bit, but couldn't get the job done. North Ballarat City were just far too impressive here. William Young booted five goals for the winners, and yeah, now they're equal on points. If we take a look at the ladder, so North Ballarat 7th, Melton South 8th, still both can make the top 6 and play finals, but geez, it's really heating up there.
It is, the Lakers and Bacchus Marsh, we can see, only lost the one game, had a draw as well. Now we go up to the real rivalry here between the Pigeons and Albury Tigers, and the Tigers have been a very dominant side.
Yeah, it's scary. I was actually at this game, boys. It was one of the fieriest games I've seen. It's a wonder nobody was reported. The little spot fires across the field for most of the game. I said before, it was scary how good the Tigers are. Dean Polo and Daniel Cross, two of their former AFL players, weren't playing, and they still got the job done.
Do you, given your pension for getting out and having a kick, do you go out at quarter time and half time and three quarter time when you go and watch games up in the bush?
Well, I was saying to Ryan, my cameraman friend who I was with, I wish we had have had a footy. I wouldn't have minded having a kick at quarter time.
What about the South West District Footy League ladder?
Yeah, well, the win to Heathmere on the weekend means that they will play finals for the first time since 2011, which is a massive deal for them considering they didn't win a game last year. And Tyrone Darrow, who finished in sixth, they were the reigning premiers, so they've missed out. Very interesting there.
Yes. A lot of cousins play footy together, Pix and Nath. Mm. And, well, we've done our homework. And there are nine cousins who are currently playing with Eden Hope Apsley Saints in the Horsterman District Football League. Sean Stephen, John Matthew, Jack Leslie, Taylor Butler and Michael and James Brown. All from one extended family. Row, I should say.
I was going to say, James Brown's
they
a
look
singer.
Like Browns. But nine cousins all playing footy together. I think that's a record, is it not?
I would be. I'm sure of it. But it's where the McDonald boys started, wasn't it?
Yes, Eden Hope. Absolutely. Hey, and we then cross over into the Greyhounds and three dogs from the same litter. Jane's Intention, a yellow. Ed's Intention in the blue and Flash Intention in the white by Barsha Vale.
I did.
The Pickers mucked it up last week out of Uno Lesson. And a bred by Todd O'Neill at Pearstar. That's a good effort. Three dogs in the one race.
It is, but I mean, none of them got the jockeys, which is a little bit disappointing. Yeah, second, third and sixth there. The white dog came sixth.
Well, you get a ribbon for finish for competing in sport now, Pickers. So I reckon that's a good effort to have three dogs in the same
you
race.
You've got to turn up to training first, last to leave. You get best clubman.
Or a best clubman award. One of the two.
We've got to take a break. Social media, get involved. Let us know what we're doing well and certainly what we're not doing well. Thanks, Nath. When we come back, Hannah Driscoll from the Weekly Times with the Weekly Wrap. Welcome back to Off the Bench for the TAC Towards Zero. It's time now to jump straight into our weekly wrap. That's all thanks to the Weekly Times, the voice of the country, as we welcome our regular co-host, Hannah Driscoll from the Weekly Times. Welcome, Hannah.
Thank you very much, guys. How are we going?
We're going well. Tell us about this AFL International Cup, Hannah.
So the AFL International Cup kicked off at the weekend. It runs through to August 19. But one of the big things of note for this is that some of the games are being played in country Victoria. We're looking at footage from India and Pakistan's games from earlier this week. And those two teams, big cricket rivals, yes, obviously, but they're actually playing a football match in Golden Square tomorrow night. The India team has been hosted by Golden Square when they first flew in last week. They went along to their training. They had a practice match against some of their younger players. So fantastic initiative for Golden Square to be hosting. And they're hosting that game tomorrow night as well.
Good luck to all the teams in the International Cup. What of the Donald Football Club that's quite innovative?
Yes, they've been a bit entrepreneurial in the past, has the Donald Footy Club. They invested in a football farm back in the 1990s, and now they're looking at taking over the lease of the local caravan park, which is actually very close to the football club in town. It's got the benefits of not only a new financial stream for the club, but also it's going to be a community-run organisation and hopefully keeping those funds in town.
Well done to the Donald Football Club for thinking outside the square. Or on this occasion, outside the caravan. Now, it's a bit of Yuri time.
No.
Photo of the week time with Yuri, our favourite.
This is from the Geelong and District game on the weekend, Bannockburn and Belvoir Hill. And on a serious note, the Bannockburn captain Brad Watts did suffer a serious kidney injury from this. So our thoughts go out to him and hopefully he makes a speedy recovery.
Yeah, well said, Hannah. Thoughts with Brad and his family. If you'd like to read Hannah's articles or get the latest national rural news, then that's the place to go. If you'd also like to let Pickers know how good or bad that joke was, then send the emails there to that place as we head to the break. Let's have a look at the second of our City of Ballarat feature stories. AFL footy's coming to Ballarat next week when the Western Bulldogs host the Port Adelaide Football Club for four premiership points. And a man who's been attached to the Western Bulldogs now doing some important work in the City of Ballarat, his name is Brett Goods.
Brett Goods, my title at the Western Bulldogs is Ballarat Engagement Manager, so that means a whole lot of different things, but so living in Ballarat and sort of managing our shop front here as well.
Brother Adam, one of the most decorated players to ever play AFL football. And look, when you're aspirational as well, it would be difficult living in the shadows. But I think from the stories Brett told me about, Adam was just a wonderful support for him right through, as was the rest of his family.
I suppose I actually gave up on the idea of me ever playing AFL footy, and that was at, I think, 26. Lucky enough to get a job back at the Western Bulldogs 12 months later.
Well, obviously he was here under our nose working as the player development manager, and Brendan McCartney, who was coaching at the time, the boys went away on an end of season trip, which they played an exhibition game. And Brett was part of that from probably the coaching and welfare component. And Macca had had a conversation with him about the opportunity maybe to just do a pre-season and see how he went. So it evolved from that. We actually gave and offered Brett a rookie spot on the list.
It doesn't matter if you're Bob Murphy or if you're a young player, you know, that's 3 years in and looking at the possibility of getting delisted. You've got to think about it. I felt comfortable at the time when it was happening, and it was just lucky enough at the time that the Bulldogs were expanding into Ballarat.
Throw it up. I'll tell you what I'm going to leave here. Now, so I know I've won the hit, so I'm not going until I've known Richo's hit it. I don't want us running too early because that's what we do it too early, Richo loses it. Willow's here, opposition gets an easy footy.
It's really nice now that he sees his involvement in footy a bit more now about others and what influence I might be able to have on other people. And I think that's really nice and it says a lot about Goodsy as a person.
Brett, in his own right, has been a really good footballer at country, at state level then to get that AFL opportunity and acquit himself really well. But it's then what he stands for as a person in the community. Ballarat has been a wonderful initiative for this footy club, and that really fitted well for Goodsy to make that transition again to the next phase.
The thing I really liked about this job in Ballarat is that, yeah, I was coming back to a place that's very familiar and that I did call home for a long time, but being able to work across the club in so many ways is why I really did wanted to come back in this role, and to build something up from the ground to bring AFL footy here as well was a big part of it.
Yeah, welcome back to Off the Bench. Thanks to the TAC. Time for our great country footy clashes, and that's all thanks to the Towards Zero campaign. With safer speeds, roads, users and vehicles, a zero road toll and serious injuries is achievable. Where are we going today, Pix?
The Alberton Football League, real good rivalry here between Toora and Fish Creek.
Wayne Wiedemann's old team.
The Creekers are interesting. It is Wayne Wiedemann. It is. Like Barry Stanfield might come from Fish Creek. I'm going for the Kangaroos from Fish Creek.
Right.
I think they'll continue on their merry way. They're 15-1 so far, so good luck to Fish Creek.
So we're both on the Kangaroos. Good luck to them this week. Pickers, you've been pretty good today.
Just hanging in there,
did
really.
Did Pardo give you a name?
Got a couple in the Isle under 18. Got a couple. Keep an eye on
that. Yeah, good luck to the GWV Rebels for the remainder of the year. Half a game out of the eight with the TAC Cup competition. Good luck to all the football and netball teams right across the great state of Victoria. And if you are on the roads this weekend, then heed the advice of our partners, the TAC, and make sure that we get to our end destination safely and within the speed limits. Have a great weekend, everybody. See you again, same time next week.